Y'all, what I was just thinking about, super random. I was just like, wow, I've had this car for since I came off to college in 2014. It's 2023 now. And even before that, my mom had it like a year before me. So, and I'm just very grateful. Whenever I think about like maybe getting a new car, obviously I think about like financial aspect of it, but I'm just like, I don't really need it. I'm very thankful for my car, and I'm very thankful that, I've had minimal issues with my car. Like, car troubles really stress me out, and I don't know a lot about cars, and I get nervous whenever I have to go to like a mechanic or anything. I'm like, please don't rip me off. But I'm just really grateful for a reliable car, and that God has kept me from any car issues and car troubles,
Protect your eyes. Protect your crusty lips. I consider myself a lip balm, lip oil, lip moisture connoisseur, and this by far the Clinique Moisture Surge Lip Hydro Plump Treatment is one of the best. I wish it was like tinted because I do like little tinted things, but she's great. She's great. I'm ready.
Is even open. I'm gonna stop by Home Goods and kill some time before stopping by Ulta. All right, y'all. I had to get changed because I started cleaning my kitchen. And I'm at like 10 minutes. So while my bread is breading, I spill some tea. No, I'm just kidding. It smells so good. It smells like banana, of course. I had to get changed because after cleaning, I was putting away clothes, and then I got a little mugrosa, and then I was like, I don't want to film like this. So I just
changed a little bit. I'm gonna go shower later, but just so y'all know, it's still the same day. Listen, God has slapped me in the face in the best ways possible. I love learning new things. And as I've been sharing, I've been going through a lot of changes and been in a place of a lot of trust with God. And the last podcast that I watched was how to deal with your paralyzed potential. And a lot of it was literally talking into my situation right now. Why is this hurting me good? It's just what I've been talking about, which is fear and anxiety have held me back from a lot of things as far as things that God has put in my heart and potentials. It's just like I didn't see myself walking into a creative aspect in my life. When you're creative and you create something, putting that art out is very scary. But I know that that's the season that God has called me to. This is a time of my life that God has called me to. I don't have a lot of experience, and I understand that, like, when God calls, you know, like, go. He's gonna provide for you. Like, you don't need to be, like, a professional. You don't need to be, like, he's gonna equip you. I understand that. But, like, then to, like, walk in it and feel like you're walking, like, the floor has been completely stripped below your feet, because at this point, you have no choice but to walk. Well, you can walk away. You can walk away and choose differently, of course. You can reject that. But you're just like, okay, I know that God is calling me to do this, and it's scary. I had already been trusting God in different areas of my life, and now it's like a full trust moment. I have 2 minutes till my bread is done, and I'm not going to start crying right now. I think from an outside perspective, you know, you might just be like, Brianna, like, you're in worship, you're a youth leader, you've been a Christian your whole life, like, whatever. I'm like, I still have to trust God. Like, I'm still his daughter. I'm still being taught new things. And this is part of why I started vlogging and why I've started this, in hopes to share what a walk with God looks like. I'm gonna go get my banana bread. I'll be right back. All right. I'm back. And I just wanted to do a real as it's happening moment. I love sharing my testimony of the places where God has brought me out of. I have surely seen God work in my life before, and that's why when he calls me to even bigger things, I'm like, have we not been through a lot? Chill. I started writing songs, and I showed it to my leaders. And that was a lot for me. And so now to be in this place where I am sharing my life in these vlogs, being vulnerable with other people, and just kind of sharing a real account of what God is doing in my life currently. It's a lot, it's uncomfortable, it's very vulnerable. And now to be going to a recording sesh, and I don't know, like, what to expect. I don't feel the most equipped person, but I know who has called me. And that's where I draw the line between I've processed what I'm feeling. I have laid it all out to God. I feel insecure. Sorry. I feel so uncomfortable. I feel like crying. I feel like throwing up. I feel like I'm not even that talented, to be honest. And Tim Ross was talking about that, like you could be humble and confident. Yeah, I'm working on that. But yes, this is where like my humanity like ends, and I begin to walk in God's promises because I know it's not because of me or because I'm so talented. And yeah, I may have some talent, but this is where Tim Ross is talking about like a partnership with God, where I'm going to serve God and be obedient to Him with my talents, with the things that He's placed in my hand, and not keep it to myself. I don't know where this is going. It's a big unknown. It's a lot for me, to be honest. But, and, you know, I have that fear of failure, and we might fail. Who knows? Hopefully not. But God is faithful, and at least I'm giving Him my yes, and I'm going to walk in that authority that He's given me and work on that humility and confident area of my life. It's very uncomfortable the way that I speak about myself. Like if you guys watch my vlogs, this is all kind of like leading up to that. I've been very confronted with the way that I speak about myself because it allows me to hide. It allows me, and it's just not what God's thoughts are about me. It doesn't encourage me into the places and purposes that God has called me to. So here we are. I'm going to choose to be excited, and embrace the things that God has called me to at this time of my life. I'm still getting a little comfortable speaking to a camera and putting out videos and vlogging. But of course, I'm going to find some fun in it and embrace it. And hopefully, it's edifying to someone's life, to be part of someone's journey as they're trusting in God, as they're faithfully walking and see what God does in my life. But yeah, that's where I am. Hopefully I will share a little bit more. I'm a little bit overwhelmed, but I refuse to allow the enemy to steal more from me through anxiety and fear. Because God has called me for such a time like this, and I'm laying down humbly, like all my fears and anxieties at God's feet, and trusting Him in the places He's called me to, that He's given me authority to walk in this place. And that this is where I'm going to see Him provide. This is where I'm going to see Him sustain and do even greater things with my obedience. So I just want to share that. I'm gonna go try a piece of my banana bread. All right, trying out my bread. I got the butt. This with milk, it's gonna be fire. I don't know if I concluded when I left. I got a little bit nervous. I got a little bit overwhelmed talking about songwriting and recording and just the things that God, and just the things that God has like been calling me to, and the places where I'm trusting God right now. It's just, I started sweating a little bit, but I will try to share more about that experience. Take you guys with me on my journey, trusting God. And hopefully share maybe some of the songs
in the future with you guys. We shall see. We shall see where this road, where this journey takes us. But
bye.